Okay, let's have a go at this A-level question. It reads, a rope 100 centimeters long is cut into two pieces to make a square and an equilateral triangle. Find the smallest possible area. Okay, so we're gonna have to find the area of a square and a triangle, find the total area, and then derive it to find minimum area. Okay, so always start with a diagram. There's 100 centimeters. And out of that, we're going to make a square with sides S and a equilateral triangle with sides X. And we know that the area of a square is S squared, and the area of a triangle is half the base times the height. Okay, now first thing is we don't know what the height is here. It's not given to us. So if we use Pythagoras, we can solve the height by saying that the hypotenuse is x, the base here is half of x, and here's the vertical height that we're going to solve. So we would say then that the height is the square root of c squared, which is x squared, take away half x squared, and all of that is square rooted. Okay? Now, when I start to expand this out and try and simplify it, I'm going to get half squared, I'm going to get a quarter, I'm going to have 1 take away a quarter x squared. And it could start to look a little bit messy. So we could take a different path here and say, let's make the sides of this triangle 2x. That would make this hypotenuse 2x, and it would make the base here 1x. Okay? And you're allowed to do that to make your work a little bit simpler, easier. So the height now is going to be 2x squared, take away x squared. Okay. And that simplifies to be 4x squared take away x squared, which is 3x squared. And 3x squared with a square root is the same as the root of 3 times by the root of x squared. And we can simplify that and say that this is now the square root of 3 times x. Okay, that worked. That comes out quite nicely. Then we have the area of this triangle, half the base, which is, the base is 2x, times the height, which is root 3x. And the half and the 2 will cancel, leaving us with root 3x squared. Then we have the square, and S in this case is going to be 100 centimeters, subtract 6x that was used for the triangle, and so that's what's left over. So if we said that 6x was used for the triangle, that leaves this side, which is 100 take away 6x. Okay, so that's how much rope would be left to use the square. And the square has 4 sides to it. If I wanted one side, I would need to divide that perimeter by 4. So I can simplify this and say that S is equal to 25 take away 3 onto X. So if I want the area of the square, I would have to square S. Like so. Okay. So I now have the area of my square, I have the area of my triangle. That means that my total area would be the area of the square summed with the area of the triangle. The area of the square is here. 25 take away 3 onto x all squared. Add it to the area of the triangle, which is root 3x squared. And that's fine. And so now we're ready to derive the combined area to find a minimum. So let's do that. This is the total area derived. Let's bring down the power 2, use the chain rule. The power 2 now becomes a power 1. I've derived the outside, let's now derive the inside. The derivative of this is going to be negative 3 on 2. That's the square done. Now let's derive the triangle. We're going to get 2 root 3 x to the power 1. Okay. We can simplify the 2 and the negative 3 on 2. And now we're looking for a minimum which occurs when the derivative is equal to 0. So let's make this function now equal to 0, and we get this equation. And let's see if we can solve for x. Let's start by expanding the brackets. Negative 75 add 9 on 2x plus 2 root 3x is equal to 0. I can factorize the x's. I'm not going to forget the negative 75, and all this is still equal to 0. Move the negative 75 over, divide off these two terms, and I get x is equal to 75 all over 9 on 2 plus 2 root 3. Okay, and that's going to come to 9.42. So we know now what the value of x is going to be when a minimum occurs. Let's verify that it is in fact a minimum, because we have a function, and when the derivative is equal to 0, it could be that we have a maximum, or it could be that we have a minimum. Now, we need to verify that we do in fact have a minimum at 9.42. So we're looking for a negative slope, a zero slope, and a positive slope. That's going to verify for us that we have a minimum. So let's do that. Create a table of coordinates. Like so. And our answer 9.42 is going to go in the middle. To the left, let's use 9. To the right, let's use 10. Okay. So you want a coordinate for x either side of where our minimum should occur, and not too far away either. Okay. Now, we've already solved for when the derivative is equal to 0. So at 9.42, we know the derivative is 0, and the gradient then is going to be horizontal. All right. So if we put 9 into the function, the derivative function, We're looking for a negative answer. So, plugging 9 in, we're going to get negative 3 times by 25, take away 3 on 2 times 9, plus 2 root 3 times 9. Okay, so negative 3 times 25 is negative 75. Add 9 on 2 times 9 plus 2 times 9 makes 18, root 3. And this 9 times that 9 makes 81. And 81 divided by 2 makes 40.5. And let's come up with an answer. And we get negative 3.3. Okay, so that's clearly negative, and so we've got a negative slope. Let's plug 10 into the function now and see what we come up with. Negative 3 times 25, take away 3 on 2 times 10. Plus 2 root 3 times 10. Okay. So, negative 75, add 3 times 3 times 10 is 90 over 2, plus 20 root 3. And 90 divided by 2 is 45. And let's come up with an answer for this one. We get 4.64. And that's positive, greater than 0, this was less than 0. So this was positive, and we have a positive slope. We can say, therefore, there is a minimum at x equals 9.42. Okay. Right, so we verified the minimum. We haven't actually solved what the combined area is, so let's plug 9.42 into our original function. Which is right here. And we get 25, take away 3 on 2. Times 9.42 squared plus root 3 times 9.42 squared. Okay. And all of this comes to 271.85 centimeters squared. So there you have it, there's the minimum area. Don't forget to write a conclusion. Therefore, the minimum possible area is 271.85 centimeters squared. And that is an A-level question.